All right, read it and maybe weep. 77%, nearly 8 out of 10 Americans, extremely or just very worried about crime and what is now rampant in at least a dozen U.S. cities, looking at all-time high spikes in serious crime, murders, and robberies. James Craig, the former Detroit police chief, probably not at all surprised by those findings. Chief, it's very good to have you back. I think the biggest sort of read I got from a lot of these polls and these numbers coming out of Fox Business is that people are beginning to fear the government is losing touch with how serious this is. They're worried about it. They're not sure their elected officials are. What do you say?
You know, Neil, first of all, let me say Merry Christmas to you. Thank you for having me on your show. But we start talking about crime, I also want to offer my prayers out to that Baltimore City police officer that's recovering from the cowardly act and when she was ambushed last night. But no, I'm not surprised, Neil. This doesn't surprise me one bit. Let's start with the White House. When you start talking about crime, Jen Psaki, the White House pivots. They don't address it. They don't talk about the real issues. And as tragic as the situation was last night, even the mayor said, well, we don't want to get into propaganda. Look, I've been talking about it for months, Neil. You know, on your show, many other shows, we have got to continue to talk about really what's driving crime. We have rogue prosecutors, rogue judges who are not doing what's right. You have a mayor in Chicago that says the best thing to do is retailers go out and hire security. What she has lost sight of, that she's a public servant and her chief responsibility is to create public safety. So why would you even think it's okay to dismiss it? The Philadelphia district attorney, chief law enforcement officer in that county, makes a statement in addressing the rising homicide that is kind of squishy. I saw him this morning and he kind of went in a softer direction. But the bottom line, we have got to stop evading the real issue, because I don't care how much money you throw at law enforcement, how many police officers you hire, the issues are still the same. Police officers feel demonized, demoralized, they're resigning, and the pipeline to hiring is just not there.
So what happens if none of this is addressed? So we don't look at underlying issues such as, even arresting those who might steal up to a certain amount. That isn't happening in California. I'm just wondering where all this goes.
Well, it's going to continue to happen, Neil. If you just ignore the thefts in California, and say, well, we don't want to worry about that, but we've seen instances where the suspects engaging in this activity are getting increasingly more and more aggressive. And so we can't ignore it. It's the broken windows. We have got to get to the core issues. The White House has to address it. Those so-called moderate Democrats can no longer just sit back and say nothing because they're complicit. I listened to the mayor out in San Francisco, and she's saying enough is enough, but it's not enough. You have got to do what's right. And look, this is a concern for all Americans. This is not about party. This is about what's good for our country. This is about what's good for our state. And when folks who sit in these seats, they're politicians. They are not addressing the core issues.
And that's the fear, and it's proven in polls. James Craig, thank you very much, Chief. We appreciate it. Have a Merry Christmas.
Hey, Sean Hannity here. Hey, click here to subscribe to Fox News YouTube page and catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis. You will not get it anywhere else.